So I recently posted a photo of my natural themed rat enclosure on Facebook and it got over 3,000 shares. You guys practically demanded a cage tour, so here it is. This is my crew of 9. They live in a triple critter nation, which is essentially 9 cages connected as one giant cage by removing the inner walls and using metal zip ties. Peppa will make an appearance later at the end of the video. She was busy digging a hole. As I mentioned before, I have 9 rats in this enclosure. Though the American cage calculators state 63 rats can live here comfortably, I truly believe there's a difference between thriving and surviving. Rats have incredibly intelligent little minds, and they need a lot of space to thrive, which includes a lot of space for enrichment items, like this wooden chinchilla toy I'm pointing to here from Beyond Normal Oddities on Etsy. Among their other favorites is the clear plastic parrot toy. They really have to think to figure out how to get the treats out of each section, so it's a great enrichment item. I have various types of safe chewing rope suspended throughout the cage as fall breakers and boredom breakers. They really love their choya wood, among other various species of dried out wood in the cage. Be sure to check the type of wood you're planning on using is rat safe before you put it inside of your enclosure. Some of the other wooden items I have are these hidey houses meant for guinea pigs from Petco. In the top section of the cage, we have mostly a few hammocks, a tree trunk swing, which is suspended by a chain that can hold well over 30 pounds, so it's totally safe for a few rats to climb on all at once. All of the hammocks are natural themed or natural inspired. And we have a chinchilla hideaway in the back corner. We have a couple of dried oak ledges on the sides. And this level has choya wood suspended from different sections, as well as all of the other levels, creating little bridges from one section to the other. The bottom base is a giant 9x2x2 bioactive section of the cage. All of the upper levels are removable litter trays that have 10 centimeter plastic guards that keeps the substrate inside of them. I'm not going to go too in depth to the bioactive aspect of this cage in this video, but I would be happy to do so in another video. Moving on to the middle section of the cage, we have the infamous dollhouse that I put in every single enclosure ever because I love them. That, of course, sits on the base, which is 61 centimeters tall, or 24 inches if you're in the US, like I am. It keeps, no matter what type of substrate you choose, from getting out, and I have the entire thing lined with a metal bar going around the top and all the seams so that my rats can't chew the very expensive litter box I just built them. The dollhouse is actually suspended on 2 metal bars, so it can't fall over. Even if they dig underneath it, it'll just become a little wobbly. I included that as a safety feature because they really enjoy tunneling underneath it, and I didn't want them to get crushed. In the very center of the cage, we have my favorite item of all in the entire enclosure, which is an ethically sourced deer skull. I've used skulls in my enclosures for a few years now, but this one is overall more aesthetically pleasing than anything else. We have a couple of hammocks on each side, a few natural themed toys, and in the background we have some DIY pipes that I've made myself with various openings as like portals or windows they can view out of or climb out of if they prefer. Underneath the custom tubes I have 2 adorable little bird huts, often used for finches or mice, but the rats seem to enjoy them a lot. They get destroyed quite quickly, so don't expect them to last if you decide to invest money in them. In the future, I can either make a video on how to do a bioactive cage for rats, or I could do a time lapse on cleaning this cage because a lot of people seemed really worried that it would be a massive undertaking when it's actually not that bad at all compared to some of my other cages. Moving on to the upper section of the cage, I have a bunch of different large pieces of driftwood that the rats have really been loving over the last several months. They span across entire units because some of them are so large, so they create ample space for running and safe climbing. They lead up to two of those roundabout, rollabout balls that people often use for hamsters but aren't super safe. So I found a way to use the ones that I've been donated by suspending them up in the cage with a metal zip tie and filling them with some type of substrate like crinkle paper, fleece, or something else. They like digging it out and getting it all over the cage. In between the two balls, Mike is showing off the suspended level or hanging box from my Etsy shop, which can again hold 30 pounds of weight or more. So I've mentioned wood a couple of times in this video. Some of my favorite places to buy wood that can be used in rat cages, like driftwood or choya wood, is from your local reptile or aquarium shops. They generally sell it far cheaper than any pet store does. Check different online suppliers as well. Some people live where this stuff is naturally found and they will sell it on places like Etsy. In the next section of the cage, on the far side, we have a really long, elaborate staircase made out of wood slices, a couple other DIY tubes, some rope, hammocks, and one of those little igloo things from Petco. Of course, there's more choya wood over here. I have a bird toy hanging from the upper level suspended out of one of my older cages. They actually seem to enjoy that. On some of the doors, I have perches from the bird section in different stores, which can also be made. Here you can see I'm putting Bailey into the hole of one of the chinchilla-themed hideaways, and she's quickly running back down because she thinks she's about to miss out on a treat. Everyone thinks it's treat time when the doors open. They believe they've been deprived of treats, even though they had some shortly before this. They explore every inch of this cage as stuff changes and I take things out for maintenance or cleaning. They constantly feel like it's a new environment, and I've seen them really thrive in this naturalistic setup because there's so much more enrichment for them to be able to dig, play, climb, and chew on all sorts of items in the cage. In the top section, I have several items that I have in other areas of the cage because I like to have duplicates of things. There is a tree trunk swing, more links of rope connected on different sides of the cage, more choya wood, a couple of hammocks, another DIY tube, and in the far corner there is a hexagon style chinchilla hideaway that is also from my Etsy shop. I think that one is really neat, and I've seen them use it to climb onto the roof of the cage several times now, so it's actually what I believe Bailey is doing in the video right now. She'll probably use that to get back down because she's quite mischievous and doesn't always come when called unless a treat is offered. There she goes inside of the cage, and now I just have to wrangle everyone else up and put them somewhere so they don't get their little toes caught inside the doors. Because that's never fun.
Thank you guys for watching this cage tour, for commenting, liking, and subscribing. The support you guys have shown me this last year on social media has been absolutely phenomenal, and I'm really pleased that so many people are interested in the enclosures I've been building, the things I've been doing. It's kind of crazy, honestly. I look forward to making more videos and talking with you guys. Until next time.